Lighting is one of the most difficult parts of creating a photorealistic visualization. But don't worry, as today you will know how to easily create daylight scenario like in this image. I will be using the living scene from our visualization training. If you want to check it out, the link will be in the corner and in the description below the video. When working on lighting, I like to have standard gray material applied to all objects. However, we need to add glass for the windows so the environmental light can come through. The easiest method will be to create Corona physical material and choose a glass from the preset. Apply the material to the windows. Next, let's go to the settings and enable material override. This way, we can be sure that whatever objects we have in the scene, even if they already have some materials applied, they will render with the specific material we will choose. But we have to exclude the glass objects so the light can travel inside. For this interior, we'll go with the standard CoronaSun and Sky setup. Let's go to the Lights tab and choose CoronaSun. Next, just draw the sun in the top view. If you click 8 on your keyboard, you'll open the Environment and Effects tab. You'll see that we have no map here. Click Add CoronaSky to the environment to quickly add the sky as well. Let's see how it looks rendered. Looking good, but we'll do some tweaks. Firstly, we'll work on the sun position. It will be nice to have a bit of sun on the sofa. It will make our image look more interesting and add a bit more life to it. Always try to test various positions and choose the one that looks the best and suits your idea. Great! Now we can work on the shadows. We can make them softer. To control that, we have to change the sun's size. Let me quickly show you how it works. I duplicate the view so we can compare the two versions. Now you can notice that when we do a very small size, the shadows are super hard. And if we do a very large size, the shadows are nice and soft. I will go for something like 5. Great, looking nice. Next, let's go to the settings and set up the light mix. Thanks to that, we can control lights in the scene separately. We have to start interactive rendering again. Go to the Light Mix tab. And here it is. I want to make the sun less intense. I think something around 0.1 looks well. This way the blue color of the sky is way more visible. We can make the image more interesting by adding some extra shadows. I'll use the tree model for that. By the way, in the course the models are included, so you don't have to worry about anything. We have to position the tree to block the sunlight. Let's turn off the sky, so only the sun is visible. Start positioning the tree. We definitely have to move it down. I show you a great trick. Go to Lights and choose CoronaSun to see exactly the direction of the sun. It's too far away, so from that view, I will switch to the perspective view. We have roughly the same angle. Now, we just have to move the tree in small increments and see what works best. Spend some time on that. It will add soft shadows to the image. Let's decrease the size a bit. The shadows were too soft and wash out. I work a bit longer on the tree position. Turn on the sky, so we'll see how it all works together. When we're happy with a tree position, let's move to setting up the interior lights. We'll add the lamp models first. I choose a pendant and table lamp. Let's start with the main light. I will position it in the center of the image and move it up a bit. You can see that it's too short. We'll fix it later, but first, let's position the side lamp here on the shelf. I'll move it up. Okay, now let's go back to the pendant lamp. Let's ungroup the model. I will move this element up. I'll zoom in on the view to see the details better. And with the cable, I have to go into the vertices settings and move some of them up. And the problem is gone. Go to the settings and exclude these materials from the override. We need to do that so we can see how the light will affect the scene as the lampshade's material is translucent. Great, we can stop interactive rendering for now. Open the group and hide this element so we can see inside. Here we have the bulb. I will create a spherical light inside. Adjust the size. Move it down a bit. I will actually align it to the center of the light model. Let's see how it looks rendered. Turn off the other lights. We have to unhide the cover. I will make it way warmer. Let's see how it looks with other lights. I have to make it stronger. 2.5 times works well. I will just reset this to 1 and set it up in the Corona light settings. I will make it a bit warmer as well. Okay, I like it. Let's do the table lamp now. I will copy this light to the other model and align it to the center of the model. Move it up and decrease the radius to 1.5. It's a bit too small, make the radius a bit bigger. Go to the settings, add two lights, select render elements, and change the names. The first layer we can call a ceiling lamp, for instance, and the second, side lamp. Add our new lights there so you can control it in the light mix. Let's render it so we can adjust the side lamp. Let's increase the intensity. At the end, I show you the trick how to make the darker shadows. I will create a box that will imitate the ground. I will change the color to red to show you something. But first, we have to exclude this object from material override. You can see that we have this red tint in the corner of the image in the shadows. We can use this ground model to make the interior a bit darker or a bit lighter depending on your needs. I will apply the new material to the ground object and make it way darker to make the shadows in the ceiling a bit darker. If you want to learn more about this technique, watch my tutorial. The link is in the corner and in the description below the video. I think that helps a little bit. Lastly, I will increase the intensity here in the settings and reset the light mix value to 1. Also, I will make it a bit warmer. Great, here is the final effect. If you want to learn how to create beautiful visualizations from start to finish, check out our training. You can also stay here on YouTube and watch more tutorials. Bye-bye!